Welcome back, my friends. This is Chapter 8. I have no future here. And the only thing I can think is, whose fault is that? Oh, it's been a little bit since I sat down to record one of these, mainly because if I read too many of these in succession, it starts to make my brain feel like it's melting. So, I had to take a little break. But oh, we're right back to exactly where we started with this one. Not much has changed, so we just keep doing the same thing every chapter. So after his little stint in juvie, you know, after the fight that he initiated with his father to prove how much of an alpha male he truly is, the school expelled him. And he describes this as if it's something terrible. My life is often not more than a series of tragic events, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah, it is. And they're all of your creation. Imagine that. Yeah, he goes in this whole thing about how he didn't want to be expelled, but now he is, and he just can't seem to fathom why. You continually caused problems at school. You got into more than one fight. You assaulted someone, and now that you've been arrested, it gives them all the reason they need to say, yeah, you're a danger to the rest of the people in this facility, so you can't come back. Why are you surprised by this? I don't even understand where you're trying to go with this. And again, the go-to, like, kind of rationale would be that he is, in fact, a teenager, and a teenager would not be able to think these things through, except that he is not a teenager. Onision wrote this book as a grown man. An adult would know these things, an adult would be able to find a way to make these things work, except that is not what we're getting from this. No, in this, we have to learn such wonderful little things about... I mean, I've already said it's just Greg, but let's just keep going with that because it is. We get to learn more wonderful things about the way he sees the world and his personality, which are both awful. But he talks about how his dad doesn't want to talk to him anymore because, you know, he read my journal and that was an invasion of my privacy. You assaulted him and then wound up in jail. I'm sure the main reason he read your journal is because the main question that was burning in his mind is, what the hell is wrong with you? Yeah, I agree. That's kind of a major question. But we already know what's wrong with him, don't we, children? We're already well aware of what's wrong with this individual. He goes on to talk about how his female lamp is the single greatest thing in his life because, you know, she has no personality and supports every single decision he's ever made, and he's effectively twisted her into just a wonderful little toy. I mean, that's what she is, let's be honest. It's a disgusting thing, but yeah. She has no personality, she makes no decisions on her own, and every chance she gets, she's intimate with him. Yeah, that is how he words it, too. I know, I threw up a little, too. So, that's a thing that we have to hear about so much. Because I get to... You know what? I'm just going to read to you this wonderful little passage. The sad thing is, I've probably slept with my girlfriend more times in the last month than he has with his girlfriend ever. Pretty sure my orgasms bring me more joy than his religion ever brought him as well. That is quite possibly the creepiest thing you could have ever said you were going to keep track of. And knowing Greg, he did keep track of it. Knowing him in his mind, that is a true statement. Not even a possible or pretty sure because I'm being narcissistic. No, that's like a fact. Which is disgusting. Why do you think about your parents having sex, Greg? Is there something you want to tell us? Is there a question you need to answer for the rest of the class? Actually, save that answer. I don't really know if I want to know the answer to that. Let's just keep going. So, they... His dad has more... We get more wonderful things from Wholesome Dad. Wholesome Dad is trying to save this kid from spiraling into just pure madness. It's not working, but he is doing his damnedest. And he is really, really trying. He is trying to get him to maybe go to a different school or get his GED and maybe not hang around this girl 24/7. Not because he thinks that she is a bad person, but because he's like a huge jerk and obviously isn't focusing on anything when she's around except her, which is not good if you've just literally been expelled. You probably need to like do something. Maybe get a job. Well, he already has a big brain super atheist plan, you guys. You don't even know. And we're going to get to that because it's a super, you know, smart guy thing. But we also get to this little tidbit. I'll just read it to you. Considering I'm expelled, there's a small part of me that still lives in reality and is concerned about my academic future. A small part. Just a little one. This little voice suggests I get a GED. I think my first goal is the good enough degree, then after that, the military. You know, I know a lot of people who got their GED and went on to become incredibly successful people, so since they're not here and wouldn't read this book, mainly because they don't torment themselves with horrible cringe writing like I do, let me be their voice in this moment when I say, fuck you. Good enough degree. Fuck right off. I don't necessarily love the idea of dying for my country, but it's a great alternative to being stuck with my father and his rotten, hairless, albino moose of a girlfriend. This is just like the cringiest shit. This is so edgelord. This is so, you know, ugh, my dad's the worst, so I'm just gonna do this thing to, like, get out of here. But not only am I gonna, like, just, I could just run away and, like, get a job somewhere, but no. I'm gonna join the army to prove how much of a serious badass alpha male I am, because I'm a serious badass alpha male. Blah, 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 blah. Lame. Well, of course he doesn't tell his girlfriend about these plans, because she might be like, that's stupid, don't do that. But, I mean, come on. She won't. She has no personality. So that's his big plan. That's his brilliant plan to get out of this house and never have to deal with his father or his father's girlfriend or anything about them ever again. But no, we're not done with this chapter yet. We get to hear Greg's opinion on vegan food, which is that he hates it because, you know, he's a meat-eating alpha male atheist super brain from, you know, just being that. Like, he doesn't have to explain himself in any way, shape, or form. He just is, which means he's better than everybody. I don't know that Onision owns a fedora, but I feel like he does. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying. And then, before we get into this next thing, before we go on to the whole vegetarian, vegan food thing, I want to point out this wonderful little tidbit that he left that I actually forgot until I just glanced over it, because it's possibly the dumbest thing I've ever seen a writer do. We have this. And you may say, but Arthur, I thought you were always motivated to insert additional idiotic comment here. I'm stupid and should shut up. You're right. You should shut up. Really? I'll give you this, Onision. You're very good at imitating a 14-year-old boy when it comes to writing this, because you are insufferable. But we're not done. Back to the food thing. He hates it, thinks it's terrible. He hates fake cheeses because vegans invented this horrible cheese that tastes like crap. Okay. What do you want, like a fucking cookie? Some people don't like things. Oh, but I'm being forced to eat it. It's not gonna kill you. Calm the fuck down, it's cheese. you're getting way too emotional over fucking cheese. But you don't know how emotional he's going to get over cheese. No, let me explain this, because it will go to places that you are beyond amazed at. So, honestly, I'm not the only person, obviously, who's read this book. And whenever I think about this particular point, because I'm only getting to this particular point, that Strange Aeons once talked about this. He goes on this whole thing about how it's these horrible cheeses, and he doesn't want to eat them, and then he has to go to dinner, and he doesn't want to eat this because of the vegan cheese. And as she put it, is exactly the way he worded this. It makes it sound like his parents called him down to dinner to be like, "Come, my child, have a dinner of cheese and cheese alone. 'Tis only cheese we eat this night. Only the vegan cheese." It's really just worded like that. It really is. He goes on a tangent about how much he hates it, and then immediately into like, "I'm not gonna eat this dinner." Is it just cheese? Is there not anything else? Like, what the hell are you talking about? So he decides he's not gonna fucking eat, and he's done, and he's just leaving. And for some reason, the reaction to this is his dad turns to the girlfriend and goes, "Call the police!" And they do. I'm serious. And his reasoning for this, the reason why he says all this stuff happened, is because his beta cuck dad is so scared of his alpha energy. He doesn't word it like that, but that's exactly what he's going for, and it's just the most pathetic thing. So, the cops show up, and they're just like, "What the fuck is this? Like, what is your problem?" And he goes in this whole thing about, like, weirdly enough, this kind of happens. He's just like, "I don't want to eat this, because it's not good." And the cop's just like, "You suck, kid." And, yeah, I mean, it's pretty much just that. And then he's decided, you know, "Now, from here on, I'm going to join the military, and then I'm just never going to come back here, because that's just... I'm just so dumb at these," and you know, you would think that this decision, I'm not even in the next chapter, that's him actually being in the military from what I understand, is, you would think that this is going to be one of those things that, like, straightens him out, you know, "Oh, he goes to the army and suddenly loses the bad attitude and becomes like a normal person." I mean, come on, this is Onision's writing. I seriously doubt that's what's going to happen. But, you know, we'll see. We will see, won't we? So far, the first half of this book, this is not even the first 10 chapters. I mean, we're only on chapter 9. Well, the next one's 9. This is 8. We haven't even passed the first 10 chapters, and this main character is insufferable, and I hate him. So I don't know how this is going to go for the rest of these. But from what I understand, there's roughly 23, if I'm not mistaken. I might be mistaken, though. So, there's only one way to find out. But this kid sucks. And this book sucks. And I didn't think this was possible, but it's worse than the last one. Because it's just concentrated suck. From the very first chapter, I assume through the whole thing, but so far, I can absolutely assure you it's from the first chapter to here. So, yeah, that's where we stand right now. But that's pretty much all that happens in this chapter. And that's pretty much all I have to say about it, because this kid sucks. That's just all there is to it. He sucks, he's an awful person, and I hate his character. And I also hate Onision's writing, but that's a different story. Except that it isn't. So, you know, whatever. It's all kind of the same. It's starting to blend together to the point that I'm getting just sick of the whole thing. But, with that being said, thank you all for being here, and I hope you're enjoying this. If you have anything you'd like to send me, stories or weird things and other, like, things you find on the internet, I guess, you can send it to r/moonhorsestories. Remember to do the whole, like, comment, subscribe thing. I don't know, YouTube changes shit every 5 minutes. I don't understand it. But either way, I'm glad you're here, and I'll see you in the next video. Goodbye!